Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to our Let's Play series with Murdock. Today I'm doing something a little bit different, and I'm doing a solo versus AI because the queue was ridiculous. So please bear in mind that we're playing against computers with computers. So how is this video any different than our previous one? It is that the last one we did was a balanced build with Murdock. So what I did was I focused on having energy damage supplemented with crit and attack speed. So each of my cards has mostly energy damage, followed with one upgrade of either attack speed or crit. Now what I'm doing here instead is I'm going to focus on crit and attack speed more so than energy damage. I want to see what happens, if that changes anything, if that changes how he plays, how he scales into the late game. I'm anticipating it's not going to go very well, but I mean, we'll have to see. I'm not entirely sure how that's going to affect him. I imagine that the attack speed will certainly be nice, but without the energy damage, the crit isn't going to really turn into anything. I anticipate. Because without the energy damage, the crits, the 150% damage on the crit, it's going to be small. So yeah, I might be critting a lot, but it's not going to be for very much. Right? So, and I'm trying something else. You also probably noticed I didn't take health mana and my health token that I have in this deck, simply because I'm going all out. Just saying. I'm just going to go all out this game. I might pick it up this time when we go back after reading. But I don't know. I don't think so. We're probably just going to go all in. So I hope that you guys enjoyed the last video. If you haven't seen it, go back. Look at the balanced build guide. Balance build let's play. This series is all just about learning how to play. I'm learning the characters, I'm learning the game, trying different things out. The whole kind of structure is that I'm playing these characters to level 3 to get that card deck, or the card pack, sorry. And then from there, once I have pick my static trap there. But, well, I'm sure we'll survive. the whole premise is that I get to level 3 with each character, I'll have some nice cards to pick from, and then from there, I can have, I can have a deck for each character as I push to level 5, and once I reach level 5, I can get that other card pack. By that point, I'm sure that I'll have, a fair amount of cards to be able to push to masters. And at that point, once I have every character to 5, every hero to 5, I anticipate that at that point I should be relatively experienced enough to start competitive play. And then of course, by that time, hopefully, the ranked system comes out, right? That is coming. They have said that it's in the works. So, as I mentioned in the last video, I am not a competitive player at all. I don't. For some reason, I appreciate strategy games, actually, much more. I appreciate working as a team. I appreciate being on the same side and just working together. You can say that this has MOBAs has that as well, but that's why I actually prefer plane versus AI, which is really, really, really silly and lame, I know. But I want to get past that. I really want to get past that. So with this focus on crit and attack speed, my first upgrade there is going to be that crit chance. That should boost us to, he has a base of 3%, I believe, and I just put 9, so we have math 12 crit chance. With the our attacks only doing 57 damage? 52. We'll have to see if this pays off. There's a crit right there. But you'll have to see if this pays off. So right now, if I had used, if I had upgraded with a energy damage upgrade, I would be doing 70. Well, 72, I think that's why I said my, or no, I said 57. I'd be doing obviously much more damage to these lanes, but I'm not sure. Yeah. Anyways, we're testing out. We're seeing which one's more valuable, which one ends up being, which one being better, and we're just, you know, trial and test it. Don't take anybody's word on it just because they say so. So this is a very boring lane phase. I would much prefer to be roaming, but. We're at 5 now. We have our ultimate, and I'm always I try to do my best to keep to stay on the lookout for possible snipe targets, but it's kind of hard to. Oh, there we go. Oh, it's so close. It's really hard. I have yet to really land a good snipe from across the map, but it'll come. I'm sure it'll come. So I don't want to push that lane too hard because I want this video to last. But I feel like with computer allies, it's actually going to be a really longer game, ironically. So once we're done here, we'll go back. I didn't optimize the card deck, my deck to have only, what is Twin Blast doing? He's just, okay, is he stuck? No, okay, jeez. And Heroes of the Storm, the elite AI, I mean, they're still a cakewalk, but if your team doesn't work together and is really quite crappy, to be honest, you can lose. You can lose to elite AIs, and I wouldn't say fairly easily, but it's definitely not unheard of. I am, oddly enough, quite excited to hopefully have different levels of AI that you can go up to against. So that just makes, you know, these videos a little bit, you know, more interesting to do versus AIs, especially solo versus AI. I know that this doesn't get any experience, which I think is kind of a shame, but it's for a good reason. They want to encourage. Sorry, hold on one moment. Alright, so we got crit. Let's do attack speed now. So we're gonna do that brutal kinetic once we're done. I probably should have picked a fury specific card there, but that's alright. We're seeing. Once again, we're just, you know, trying it out. As far as I understand, the more efficient way to increase your power with your cards is to get a card and then upgrade it fully and then move on from there. Okay, so we're fitting fairly well. that one killed him pretty well. I'm not sure. I probably would have killed her a few auto attacks earlier if I had been upgrading energy damage, but we'll see. So obviously you want to focus on your auto attack when you're upgrading your skills, your basic attack first, and then from there it depends. Yes, I mean, if you want to be safe in PvP, laying down your E, putting skills in your E and using your E as kind of like a mini ward, not really. excuse me. That's a very smart idea, obviously, because then you can put it in choke points, you can put it in areas where somebody might be coming to gank you, and then you know when they're coming, because your E will reveal them on the minimap, so you will know if somebody's coming if they step into your E. Or your right click, going into your right click, well, obviously reduce that damage that you take from the front. I am definitely not using my right click as well as I should have. I'm just trying to go all in and just try to get. So there's two here. I need some help. Will. Oop, and I'm dead. Oop, and I missed that. So it doesn't look like the computers are responding. Nope. Computers are not responding at all. So here we focused on that major wound. Now we are getting attack speed. Next, I mean, I have these few Fury-based cards here that I've just stacked with attack speed and crit. I probably should change this card here, this Merciless, to crit one attack speed. Obviously that card is meant for Grux, when he is right click, when you make the target bleed, you gain crit. Obviously that's totally meant for Grux, but I mean, you make do with what you get. Sorry if I'm not loud enough. My baby's in the next room and I don't want to wake him up and ruin the video and ruin his nap. So this obviously is a perfect example of a very stupid, incredibly stupid AI. I really do hope that they improve the AI and just make it more fun. I refuse to believe that a computer can't be made to be as, you know, challenging and rewarding to play against as a human. In this day and age, I just don't think that's an excuse. So here I'm getting this red orb. It works really, really well with Murdock because he has a passive hot pursuit where he gains 18 bonus max movement speed. So here you see, bonus damage and move speed on hit. It further increases his ability to chase down those targets and ensure that kill. So if there's a Murdock, if there's a Sparrow, I guess, but mostly Murdock and Twin Blast, they should be getting those. They should be getting those red orbs for sure. So here I'm gonna go. I'm not using my shielding shot. I should be, but I'm just gonna go two. And I'm dead. So. Back up. Okay, so somebody stepped on my. So you saw the little indicator of hitting somebody. That's That tells me that somebody stepped on my mine, which I'm trying to think of where I placed them, and I think I was wrong before when I said that they are revealed on the new map. I think I was wrong. Correct me if I'm wrong in the comments. Please let me know. So how's this going so far? Well, I'm definitely attacking fairly quick. Am I doing as much damage as I would like? I'm not sure. I'm doing 82, 124. Let's reserve judgment until the end of the game, shall we? So, I'm trying to... Without this health potion, our sustain is really kicked back. Let's get out of here. The thing about the right click is that it also slows you down a fair amount. So while yes, you're reducing the damage you're taking by 10%. 10% reduction is not very much, and ten percent isn't very much reduction, so you're still taking 90% of the damage, and you're slow at making the enemy more likely to hit you more. So it's I'm kind of treating the right click as a way to actually close with the enemy. So when you are going up against somebody, especially 1v1, you know, you can use your Q, you can and then use your right click to get to close with the enemy, and then you know that reduces your damage, and then once you're up there, use your E to put it behind them. Hopefully they back into your E. It's rooting them in place so you can hit them harder. That's kind of how I see it a little bit. So I definitely did not, optimize my cards here. So it's kind of hard to pick what to do exactly. So, you know, I'm just going to go, we're going to full out. Not even stacking any energy damage besides what's on the card, and see what happens. So that card, I don't think I'm going to do any more attack damage until I get some more crit. So that other card that I had that had two crit upgrades, I'm going to do that one next. Let's see how this works. This is not an efficient use of card power, but we're testing it out. We're giving it a shot. So our attack speed is definitely much faster, and it definitely isn't that bad. The good thing about attack speed is that it gets you more last hits, especially with minions. So it has a little bit of a kind of like a snowball effect, where you know the more that you can attack, the more that you can ensure that last hit. And then with that last hit, you get extra card power, which means you can even further upgrade your... Except I didn't get any of those last hits on the last three minions. Okay. So we're gonna back off, get this harvester. Not really working as a team here at all. I think the computers are. I'm just kind of doing my own thing. Just doing a let's play, trying to see how this works. We're gonna go come over here and help out this rampage. Against this twin blast, I don't think I'm gonna be able to do very much. We'll see. Without the health token. Oh, I definitely feel like he's hitting me much harder than I'm hitting him. But, I mean, he likes a poke character, I think. He just pokes. Do not rampage, don't go in. That was not very smart. Again, I hope that they make the AIs better. That's really quite sad, really. Okay, time to back off. Oh yeah, we're not doing much damage at all here. Look at that. Even those crits. Even those crits aren't doing much to that house howitzer. The house would probably happen there. Yeah, okay, so he does have one health. Upgrade. Though that was silly. I shouldn't have gone up there. Because those are four. Let's see, what can we do here? I think we need some energy damage. We really aren't doing much. My tower is under attack. Much energy damage. We're not doing enough damage for a hit. Let's see. This one is nice. Yeah, let's do this. So it has some energy damage, hopefully it helps a little bit, but we'll see. I think I'm gonna do a little bit of, yeah, we're gonna fill this up with some energy damage now. There's probably a proper ratio here to go with. Where, you know, one energy damage to okay, well, I don't know. If a Murdock is supposed to be able to take down a howitzer pretty easy, then that was a good indication, but I'm not sure.
An allied tower is under attack.
So let's clear this wave out. There we go, and get down a tower. Start pushing these lanes, getting the towers under our belts here. We could get that red orb. Actually, you know what? Let's go and get the enemy's red orb. Then help out our gadget and medium rules. Yeah, I'm into the. Oh, we didn't. But Flurry was gonna be stupid here. Oh! Nice! I hope you caught that. Pull! If you haven't been skeet shooting, it's a lot of fun. You should try it. Definitely go and give that a shot. So now that they died. My gadget didn't die. Where's gadget? And she's doing weird stuff. And then now that they're gone from the left lane, I'll get our red orb. Probably push. I don't know. I'll go back, heal up, and then we'll push right. Okay. Yeah, we definitely need some energy damage. It's too much crit and attack speed, not enough actual meat and potatoes here. Okay, so let's see. This one definitely has a better full upgrade bonus, so we'll do that one. Alright, so we'll start to see. Let's see if this starts ramping up. I know that there used to be an 1,800 damage crit build that must have been taken care of and rebalanced, where all what you did was you got one card that had 3%. Crit damage from the early game, and then from then on you just stacked energy damage. That was all you did, and that seemed to work out to doing 800 or 1800 damage. So maybe I'm definitely... Can we do this? Ah, for Pete's sake. So hard. So you definitely have to be really, really on. Really, really on. Alright, that's doing a little bit more damage now. Yeah, that's much better. Okay, so I'm going to go and say that perhaps there's a ratio of, you know, two crit cards, one energy damage. Once you have those three, then probably kind of a four. I don't know. You're going to have to see. What I was going to say is kind of like a, you know, a four, three crit, one attack speed, two energy damage, kind of distribution, but I don't think so. I think Murdock's gonna do much better with focusing on. Oh, and Mario's coming in. Oh, what did I do there? Is that a bug? Okay, so if you do catch what I did there, I jumped right at the moment that, Muriel, I mean, dead. Yeah, I'm dead. Okay. But Muriel was landing, and I jumped right when she was landing, and I wasn't pushed up into the air. Is that a bug? I don't know. Okay, so I'm just looking at the upgrade bonuses here. So let's do this one. Micronings. Crit chance 15%. Still not very good. I don't have very good crit upgrades. So I think this would be one much better if I had those upgrades. Should we do this crit here? No, let's stick with this. So I have 1, 2, 3 crit, 2 crit, 1, no, 1 crit. Yeah, we need to get some more crit going on here. Okay, so I'm going to try to get a crit after this next card power ding. And then, what is this twin blast doing? That's so silly. Okay, so we see there 200 damage for a crit, 230 for these minions. That's not bad, especially with how fast I'm attacking. So we definitely have to take a look back at we'll have to take a look back at the balanced. The balance build in my previous video and see how that went. In respect to this. But we'll have to see. Ugh. Too squishy. Okay, well, we're gonna go back. And that's definitely another consideration. And end game, that you should definitely have a card with some health, and even maybe some mana, maybe not mana on Murdock, but definitely some health, because he's feeling pretty squishy right now. Okay, so should we get that? We need some more. We need some crit. I don't have good crit upgrades, so that's definitely a place where we can improve. The next video on Murdock is going to be, well, A, I'm going to redo the deck and make sure that make sure that I have the appropriate upgrades to help out with the build. But the next one I'm going to do is going to be mostly energy damage. It's just going to be all... Okay. Am I dead? Oh, what happened there? Why didn't I die? Why did he jump down there? I don't know. So I'm gonna do... Oh! How did I hit that? Hilari. I'm getting just wrecked here. Murdock feels like he has a... If anything, he has a average attack range. He feels like maybe he has a little bit farther than some, but I gotta be more careful here. I think all the computers have health and mana and health. Yeah, they have health, guard, health. Yeah, they have lots of health. So players wouldn't. I don't see players putting that much points into health. So, I mean, it just makes each engagement more volatile in PvP situations. So, it rewards high damage builds, whereas this situation where each character is very healthy rewards, you know, sustained damage, where you can just, you know, stay there, do the damage, and just not die, right? So I just gotta be a little careful here. I'm extending very far. See, I didn't even notice that twin blast coming. I need to do that. I'm standing in this stuff. They're just... So I gotta be more careful, and now there's no way for me to gain back that health, so, you know, this Muriel's probably just gonna, I don't know what she's doing, but. Okay, so focus on your basic attack for the upgrades, Polaris coming in, where is he? I'm just gonna sit on my, Probably wasn't the best time to use my ultimate there. Face down my E, try to have Sparrow. Ugh, such high range. Hopefully we can finish out the Sparrow before I get back. There's some points here to spend. okay, so we're doing a fair amount of damage now. The crit... just recently in this last patch, they took down the base crit damage bonus from 200% to 150%. So instead of going from 100 and then critting for 200, your base damage is 100, and now you just crit to 150. Which it's a significant amount. I mean, 50% more W damage on a crit eccentric build is a lot. I mean, that's just 50% damage you're not doing. So, I think I might have one upgrade card. I don't even know if they're out yet. But there are upgrade cards to increase that crit damage bonus. So if you want to instead, you know, crit more than 150%, that is possible. And that is actually that's an interesting consideration if you focus on crit and crit damage bonus, what would happen there. So let's get this crit, and let's see if I have any more crit here. Okay, there's one. Oh no. This crit here. No, let's fill up this one to get that 3% of the bonus, and we'll see how this goes. Alright, can I do this? No. I should have anticipated them moving back. I'm really excited to see some great Murdock snipes on best plays, because it's gonna be amazing to see some long, like, right from, you know, right from your base to the enemy base, you know. They're just getting back, you know, they're for whatever reason walking back to their base, and then just before they get there, right from across the map. I'm really excited to see that. Okay, so we're doing a fair amount of damage here. If the computers weren't so healthy, I think it would be more successful. But I should be responding with. Okay, so yeah, I'm doing quite a bit of damage here. Yeah. Okay, so it's starting to ramp up here. I should probably I'm gonna save speculation till later. So I'm gonna actually do. I'm going to upgrade the Devastating Blast, our ultimate there. So we're going to push back this lane, hopefully get this tower, get this game on the road. I have 4 unspent card power. Oh, look at that. The crits are really starting to happen now. So I'm going to go and get the enemy's red orb. In a PvP game, this would be quite risky, but these computers... I'm gonna take that risk. What's my crit chance at now? It was at 15, we added that 3. We added another 3, so 21% crack, perhaps. Okay, so our inhibitor's almost dead over there. We should probably deal with that. But we are team of 4. So that's good. If they don't respond to that, then probably will have the advantage. Okay, so that the computer Clary knows, you know, they have instant reaction to when you see that beam coming, and then they can just leap over the hours. You know, the human player might not be expecting that. You know, it might not be expecting this thing. I mean, a good player would be expecting this thing, but okay. So I'm definitely doing a better job than the Sparrow is. She's probably much healthier than I am. So that's a fair amount of damage. We have probably a balance of crit energy damage cards at the moment. Crit and attack speed versus energy damage. This can definitely be optimized more, but that's why we are trying this. Oh, that's why we are going through the process. So I have 10 cards. I have 10 power. This Mariel. Now this Mariel, you probably kill. She's super healthy. No. I'm doing too much damage. 361. Yeah, since they rebalanced the crit, and I think they rebalanced some damage as well. There's just no way I'm doing the crit for 1800. So we're gonna round this out, get that full upgrade bonus. I'm gonna do this, get this bonus. And why not? Actually, no, I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna do some energy damage. So what's our ratio? We have 1. So 2 casts. Because it's about half and half. So half crit attack speed to half crit attack speed to energy damage. Alright, so I'm just gonna walk up this lane and make sure that these super minions don't do too much damage here. So now I'm heading for 323. And... which means I should be critting for 470. The enemy has been let's see, crit here. 480, 484. That's pretty good, ladies and gentlemen. Has it taken too long to get here? That's probably the better question. Yeah, this probably took a little bit too long. So what I mean by that is, for us to get to this point, you know, to do this much damage, to be this influential on the battlefield, it took too long. So we were too weak in the early, and I especially felt in the mid game. We felt definitely too weak in the mid game, that the enemy team would get the snowball, and then by the time you got here, it'd be too late, right? 2-3 of your inhibitors would be down, and it'd just be too late, especially versus human players. So there we have it. I think it's, this does not work. The balance felt much better throughout the whole game. So far I would say the balance build is much better. I didn't really focus on the build too much in the last Let's Play. So maybe just kind of go back and take a quick look at my cards and upgrades by the end, and I'll make sure to actually go through the cards this time. I didn't hover over those at the end of the last video. So they're pushing mid pretty hard. This was player. I mean, I'm way overextended. Like, an actual player team would then collapse on me and take me out for sure. But, I mean, they are getting pushed by their super minions, so... let's take a look at this tower. Maybe you have a snipe opportunity here? Maybe. I would like to actually get a kill across the map. But doesn't play it. Nothing that'd be too influential. Maybe. Okay, yeah. The kill doesn't play it. Okay, so this is a normal way of the game, which means our inhibitors back up. Does that sparrow there need to help out? Do we go for it? No. So this... why didn't I hit? I didn't hit that Calori. It was bang on. Okay, maybe it's either I actually missed, but I don't feel like it did. Or there's a actual finite range. Actually, no, I'm going to take this up. I might have heard my baby, I'm not sure. I'm going to take this inhibitor, go back, use these card power, and push with my team. Unless this twin boss hits me, which it should, he's smart. Okay, so let's finish off. Well, let's see, I have crit. Do you want to go full out? Well, that's the whole point. That's why we're doing this. We're going all out crit stuff. All out crit and attack speed. Okay, so what's our crit bonus? Our crit chance is 42. Okay, so let's see how this works. This is taking it to the. This is taking it to the max. Okay, well, my baby is up, so I'll have to cut this one short. What do I think? Well. I'll engage this Calori. I'll go through one little battle here and see how this goes. 457. 450, 450, 300, 457. Yeah, so we're doing the damage. But what cost? I could have definitely put more card power into energy damage. And honestly, I think I would be hitting for 450, 500 apiece. If I moved some crit into energy damage, and then from there I'd be critting for 750, a lot less than now for sure. But I think when you do the math, that would work out. So there you go, guys. Final conclusion, I think that a balanced approach, or even possibly in my next video when I do stack mainly energy damage, even that's going to be better. So we'll have to see. I don't think I would recommend this. So stacking crit to the point of 40, 40%, at least with, 2-point upgrades. If you can get, if you can get to 40, 50 percent crit with higher point cards that are more efficient, that are more efficient per point of card power, then by all means this would definitely work. We'll have to verify that with a video when I get better cards and better upgrades, but until then I'm gonna place my bets on a balanced build for Murdock or a heavy energy damage build. So there you guys have it. We had some fun with Murdock with some solo, solo versus AI gameplay. It was very weird. Don't take any of the strategy to heart. This was just to explore the build, the deck, and yeah, we're gonna stay tuned. Like the video, dislike it, subscribe. There'll be lots more Let's Play videos in the future. I hope you guys liked it. Leave a comment in the comment section for some feedback. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Take care.